Bless the beast and the children.
Hey there, bloomers and friends. It's Rev Kev coming to you from Palm Springs for another Bloom Tube. As Russ has let us know, we're coming up, it's not too long before we'll be at Bloom Tube number 150, and he is working on a special one for that. But right now we have another kind of special Bloom Tube, and that is that I have the opportunity to be with John Rodriguez, who is working with Bloom and other churches in the Coachella Valley as a part of an organization named Inland Churches United for Change, which we know as ICUC. This is the organization that sponsored my trip to New Orleans back in November, and it is it's an organization that has participated with Bloom in a couple of different ways so far, and we're working on the zoning ordinance project together with other members in the community. But John was in the office today when Russ came over, and so I said, well, let's talk to John. So John,
yes,
welcome to Bloom Tube.
Thank you.
And why don't you just tell folks, what is ICUC and what do you do?
ICUC is, like you mentioned, the Inland Congregations United for Change. Part of the PICO National Network, which started out as an institute that trained congregations and communities on how to organize effectively in the community to change things that they didn't like. And what we do and what I do as an organizer here in the Coachella Valley is meet and capacitate both pastors and lay leaders to be able to take on that role of protecting their environment, but also being able to hear what's going on in community so that they can try to address those problems as a unit. The idea is that we can build a powerful community, faith-based led organization here in the Valley that can create change, real change, like, you know, a better percentage in students graduating and going off to college rather than the 1 in 5. What about all 5? So we're dreaming big, and we think that the key to all of this is very strong pastoral leadership and very strong community leadership, and we're trying to invest in that development.
I know that our friends at San Bernardino First Congregational United Church of Christ and our friends at Riverside United Church of Christ and our friends at Redlands United Church of Christ all have been collaborators with ICUC.
Yes.
In their particular region. And we are working with John to have our participation be a part of the growth of ICUC in the Coachella Valley. Now, just one more thing. You had a success in the Dream Homes project, did you not? Can you just, you know, give us a little bit about that?
They've been working for 10 years at this, so they have
Dream Homes is the development that's on the east side of the Palm Springs Airport.
Correct.
And it is primarily
it's a very mixed community. At one point was predominantly African American, now is more predominantly Latino, but there's a very diverse mix of people live in this community. But they have a very strong core leadership that has been regarding the development of their community, very tightly knit group, and over the course of the last 10 years they've done many things as far as infrastructure and the community, but most recently they've been working on getting the opportunity to have this bike trail along their homes, and that investment is going to be about $2.2 million that we hope to leverage even more, in that it will have local jobs attached to it too. So it's a benefit for the kids, so they don't drive around in some of the unsafe streets, but also a way for recreational activity and whatnot, and hopefully a pathway to jobs. But alongside with that, they're working on solar panels for homes for low-income people that qualify, and trying to open up that opportunity for all of Cathedral City, and hopefully very soon all of the Valley, by making sure people can qualify for this program. So it's a lot of stuff that they're trying to do, but they really want to change the name of Dream Homes and the recognition that it gets that's negative, and create a positive one, just like, you know.
Have it be a positive dream and not a nightmare.
Yes.
And you work with St. Teresa Roman Catholic Church. Isn't that a group that was yes. involved in that organization?
Yes, they started in its creation, but now we are focused on creating a bigger network of clergy of different diverse faith, not just the Roman right. Catholic Church, but we think it's important that we start to talk to many more.
And we're a part of that, and that's basically what's going on. Our open leadership team has been in conversation about our collaborating with ICUC, and we worked to put a little bit of money in the budget so that we could put a little bit of money where our mouth is and do this because it's helping to build our community. This is about our following Jesus in the realm of working to benefit the least of these and to basically follow the ministry that Jesus set before us and walk in his path. And so that's what we're doing. We hope that you will join us in our congregation along those lines. Now, the truck going by is my signal that it's time to quit. So we hope you can be with us on Sunday morning in church. If you can't be with us in body, please be with us in spirit and certainly keep us in your prayers. We'll see you next time.
Thank you.
Thanks, John.
Thank you.
And the children. Give them